Hey, Harbor students. My name is Gina Abbas. I am the Student Ministry Director at Jamestown Harbor. That's one of our campuses at Harbor Churches. I am the Student Ministry Director that is old enough to be your mom. You can just call me Youth Group Mom, Mama G, because I come bearing cookies, band-aids, hugs, whatever you need. That's the best part of being a mom. I wanted to talk to you about fear. What are some of your childhood fears? Things you were afraid of as a kid? Afraid of the dark, afraid of monsters under your bed, monsters in the closet, the creepy noises in like the basement or attic, the furnace downstairs, afraid of dogs. What are some of the things that you were afraid of? I know for me, it was snakes. And I can remember going to bed and being so sure that there were snakes in my bed. I would wake up and I would cry and I would scream as a little kid, and I would beg my dad to come and check my bed to verify that there were no snakes. I have not liked snakes, no. So he would have to get a flashlight and then like show me that there were no snakes in my bed. Cause you know, like sometimes your bed sheets, they like wrinkle up. I could feel the little like wrinkles on my bed sheet, and I would like be so convinced there were snakes in my bed. And I was also half asleep. So, you know, you imagine things. Now let's talk about grown up fears. What are some of the things that now that you're a little bit older that maybe you're afraid of now? Still snakes for sure. I actually have this little like storybook that I read my kids. There's one section that has a snake in it, and I have to like skip it every time. And if my hand accidentally touches the like snake when I'm reading the story, I totally flip out. I'm like, nope, I'm so done with that. There are things that scare us. I want to take a moment and talk about a time in the Bible, a story from Matthew 8. Jesus is hanging out with his group of friends, his disciples, and they're on a small boat in the middle of the water in the Sea of Galilee. Now, they're hanging out and Jesus is taking a nap, and this crazy storm just happens. Big waves, really loud thunder, you know, the kind that you can just like feel in your chest. Jesus's friends, they are scared out of their minds. If you've ever been in a big storm and you're like, I'm going to die while I'm camping, it's not fun. Or like a tornado, you like happens. I'm from a place where there's earthquakes. I'm from California, so tornadoes are like this whole thing I've never really experienced. So I'm terrified of that actually happening. Like, can you imagine? You're like with Jesus, you're on a small boat, he's asleep, and then all of a sudden this big storm happens, and you're quite frankly worried that you are going to die. So Jesus's friends, they are terrified. They are filled with fear. They decide, we're gonna wake up Jesus. So they go and they find Jesus and they wake him up and they're like, Lord, save us. We're going to drown. We are going to die. Do something, Jesus. The disciples, they must have been feeling pretty frustrated and alone because they're like experiencing this big thing and Jesus is just asleep, taking a nap. Have you learned to appreciate naps yet? Maybe when you're a little kid, you're like, nope, don't want a nap. But as you get a little bit older, you're like, give me a good nap. Well, Jesus, in the middle of his good nap, like I mentioned, gets woken up by his disciples and he just asks them, you have little faith, why are you so afraid? And then he does calm the storm. There are a couple of things I was thinking about in the story when it comes to fear. There are things we're all afraid of. We experience fear. It's an emotion. It's a human emotion. So if you're ever afraid, congratulations, you're human. So here's the disciples, they're afraid and they wake up Jesus. Here's the thing I want you to remember about the story is that no matter how scary the circumstances, no matter how scary the situation, Jesus, he stays calm. That he is a calming presence in the middle of chaos, in the middle of what's really scary. Jesus can be a calm presence for you too. Here's the other thing I want you to think about when it comes to fear and what this story reminds me of. Don't let your confidence in Jesus get overwhelmed by the fear around you. But see, the disciples, they have Jesus with them, in the boat with them. Literally, God is with them in the boat. They're still terrified. Their confidence in Jesus gets rattled, gets overtaken by the circumstances around them, by their fear. Fear can sometimes get the better of us. Our imagination, we worry about things that will happen. We worry about things that won't happen. We're worried about saying yes to something. We're worried about saying no to something. We're afraid that if we talk to that person, they won't like us. And that person's probably afraid that you won't like them. We're afraid that maybe our parents will get divorced, or that thing that we've been really hoping for won't happen. Or we're afraid of all the craziness going on in the world. And here's what I want you to remember, that fear does not have to be the boss of you. Next time you're full of fear, next time you're afraid, next time your thoughts just run wild and you're just feeling so overwhelmed by all the what ifs and all the scary things that possibly could happen, to do this. Let Jesus be a calming presence for you. Talk to a leader, a pastor, a small group leader, a trusted friend, a parent, someone that you know has your back. Because sometimes just talking about our fears and saying them out loud, saying, Jesus, we're afraid, calm down this storm. Sometimes talking about it just helps a ton. Gives us language to kind of figure out what's going on there. And then the second thing I want you to do is to pray about it. Doesn't mean that everything's going to be magically okay, but it does show that your confidence is in Jesus and that you're just like, here, please take this. It's too much for me right now. I'm really scared. I'm really overwhelmed, and I want you to have it. Fear doesn't have to be the boss of you. Jesus is a calming presence. You can have your confidence in Jesus, and there are adults and people around you who want to be there for you in this. Fear doesn't have to be the boss of you.